The first two stories in this book describe a particularly different kind of canoe trip. There are no portages on the Rideau Canal if you are riding the hydraulic locks between Beckett's Landing and Smith's Falls. The Saugeen River is on Great Lakes lowlands and flows swiftly the more than 70 kilometers from Walkerton to Denny's Dam, also with exactly zero portages.
It's a pretty river.
Many of the other trips maintain a structure consistent with Kevin's other books, except that the portages are around rapids instead of over hills. By the time he gets to Quebec, though, they become serious whitewater canoe trips where there is little point in being there if you aren't going to attempt as many as possible. And Kevin ends with the description of a bona fide play spot, something that an inexperienced paddler would have no use for. Writing a guidebook for whitewater canoe tripping is difficult, because characterizing the flow of water down an irregular hill is particularly challenging. Even the international scale of river difficulty is highly subjective.
I think you gotta go this way more.
Since it involves evaluating risk, it depends strongly on actual conditions including water levels, experience, and the paddler's own equipment. So Kevin employs a couple of solutions. He did not classify any of the rapids. Instead, he just duplicates his source material, which was written by someone else. And he is consistently conservative. The descriptions provided for rapid classifications are too simple to be meaningful and are just silly. Everything in life is dangerous. For this book in particular, Kevin does not always explicitly state whether he portaged the Class 3s or not, but he does point out the portages exist, and nobody ever drowned while walking. The point being that the reader ultimately has to decide for themselves. In general, it will take a certain amount of experience before someone reading this book will even be able to intelligently understand it. Simply for that reason, it serves its purpose.